Hey, Benny Fish, 18th of January, 2018. And, I've been kind of busy, but boy, I'll tell you, the Lord keeps showing me all kinds of stuff. And normally, actually very rarely, I get any kind of dreams. I don't dream. I just don't. And when I do, I very rarely remember them. Yesterday morning, I'm waking up and I'm having this dream slash vision. And it's a blue box, not a pill shape, but a box. And a red box. That's all it is. And then they merge together and create purple. And then they just separate again and do it again. And it's doing this over and over in my dream. And I'm like, what on earth? And it came directly to my memory. Of the purple that I did a video on not too long ago, this Pantone color of the year for 2018. I did a video on it. The blue and red make purple. Pantone 183838, which I thought was very weird. And they've made all kinds of videos on their color of the year that, oh man, I mean, I could go through these, you guys, and just blow your mind. This is how they present their color of the year, with the pyramids. And as they're transitioning through these little slides here, you see these two lights here? Those represent the testicles, people. The blue bloods. This is how they keep their system alive. It's quite literally true. So I have, I don't know which way to go with this, because if I keep going through this video, I could keep showing you the various images that they show. You see that Lucifer devil right there? See, this is horns, his horn right there, is his eye, it's his eye, that's his mouth, his face right there. It's a freaking Satan. And this is the type of stuff that I'm being shown here. The purple. Let me get back to what the dream was. The blue and the red. What do we always consider the blue and red? They're the politicians, right? Like our friend President Trump with the purple signage, okay? I'm just saying. So I wake up with that dream, and I go and I check my headlines like I do every morning. But before I did that, I wanted to look up purple in my Bible. And I knew where I'd find it most predominantly for the times we're in. It's throughout the Bible, and it basically represents, you know, royalty, wealth, status, so on and so forth. They put a purple robe on Jesus to mock him as he was being led to his crucifixion. You understand? In Revelation, it's what the woman on the beast is arrayed in. Purple. All the merchants, all the royalty, the kings and princes. Who are those people today? Who are they? They are the presidents, the prime ministers, the kings, the congressmen, the senators, the governors. They are all of us, okay? But you have to look at the spiritual aspect of it all. For me to open up on the very morning, yesterday morning, these articles were right there in this generator here. Democrats predict a blue wave after GOP retirements, and Trump favors one side of red-blue divide. There is no divide. What's going on? And I'm telling you right now, this is what I'm getting. And it has a lot to do with this blue blood moon. It just does. It has a lot to do with it, timing-wise. There's a lot going on right now. You need to look up the blue bloods. When I search blue blood in the start page, right? I forget where the page is, but time no longer. What have they been putting out there in Hollywood where all the actors are? Okay? What did they say? Time's up? Isn't that what they said? Time's up? Well, time no longer. Just a random webpage here about the blue bloods. Mingala, all these people. You don't have to believe what I'm telling you, that these people are all in a line of spiritual blood that is wicked, dark, and demonic. It's Satan people. That's who they work for. all of them. Some of them portray themselves as wicked, evil, you know, monsters, and some portray themselves as exposing the wicked monsters, which he is doing. He's exposing people like Hillary Clinton. However, look into this man's life. He doesn't believe that he needs to confess his sins. It's just crazy. It's crazy. But nonetheless, this moon, I'm getting just very, very, very clear that this moon has something to do with it. Looking at some Blavatsky writings here, they look at this, the moon, as the queen of the night, riding in the majesty of her peerless light in heaven. Okay? That's how they look at the moon. And for this once in 151 year event that happens to fall within, what, 2 days of Candlemas, the Catholic, what they claim is the completion of the purification of Mary, Candlemas. You got to read this stuff. It's insane and it's sick. But Candlemas is also celebrated in the world of Satan. Here's a very accurate list of satanic sacrificial days. And just guess what one of them is? Candlemas. It's a blood sacrifice ritual holiday for the Satanists. This whole week, as a matter of fact, all the way up to February 2nd, is very busy for the satanic world. So I needed to share that with you, that's all. The red and the blue are one and the same, folks. I'm sorry. And you need to recognize it for what it is. You just do. Because Babylon is about to fall. And when it does, whoo boy, you best be on the right side, folks. And that is Jesus Christ, Yeshua HaMashiach, the Savior, the Redeemer. You need him. I'm just telling you, you need him. And you're going to need him a lot sooner than you think. And I want to go into a whole bunch about this. But I gots to go. So there you have it for now. Peace and grace to y'all. Many fish.
Finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Put on the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. Wherefore take unto you the whole armor of God,